Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So in this video we'll discuss the first problem of LeetCode bi-weekly contest 89. It's an easy level problem, but yeah, I would say tedious to code as compared to the other first level problem that you see. Pretty hard to code, it's pretty boring, but yeah. So the problem name is number of valid clock times. So the problem statement says that you are given a string of length 5 called time, representing the current time on a digital clock in the format RR, again colon, minute. The earliest possible time is this one, 0000, and the latest possible time is 2359. So in the string time, the digits represented by this question mark symbol are unknown and must be replaced with a digit from 0 to 9. So return an integer answer, that is the number of valid clock times that can be created by replacing every question mark with a digit from 0 to 9, right? So let's just see what the question is saying. So the question says that you are given a string, let's take the first example itself. So you are given a string question mark 500. This is the string, and what we need to do for every question mark, like here we have just one question mark, we need to replace this question mark with any digit from 0 to 9, right? And we need to tell how many valid time can we get, right? What are valid times? Valid times are basically, so in a digital clock, the time basically varies from 00 to 2359, right? These are the starting and end time. So we need to tell how many digits are replaceable or can be put at this position so that we get a valid time, right? So in this case, what are the possibilities? I can place 0 here, so it becomes 0500. This is a valid time. I can place 1 here, it becomes a valid time. Can I place 2 here? No, it's an invalid time, right? It's 2500, however the largest time can be 2359. So that is not a valid case, and similar will be the cases for all the larger digits, right? So there are just two possible values that can be that are basically replaceable. Let's take another example. So another example is, the second example is 0 question mark, then again 0 question mark, right? So there are two question marks here, and we need to tell how many valid times are possible. You can replace every question mark with any digit from 0 to 9, right? So just see here, let's talk about this digit. If I place 0 here, right, can I place 0 here? Yes, I can place. Can I place 1 here? Yes. Can I place 2 here? Yes. So I can place all the digits, right? From 0 to 9, I can place all the digits here, irrespective of whatever is present in the second half, right? Like I can place 0 here. So let's take this case. If I place 0 at the first position, it becomes 00. And this is my string, right? I have replaced this position. Now, what are the possibilities for this? You can place here 0, so it becomes 0000. You can place there 1, so it becomes 0001, 0002, and so on. It is 0009. So again, 10 possibilities, right? If I place 0 here, so I have 10 possible values that can be placed here. So it for one digit, it is 10. Now if I place 1 here, then also I'll have 10 possibilities, right? Similarly, if I place 2 here, then also I'll have all the 10 possibilities, and so on. So that means the number of possibilities here are, you can place all the 10 digits here. So total there are 100 combinations, and all the 100 combinations are valid. So in this case, 100 will be my answer, right? And now let's come to the third case. So the third example is question mark. So again, if you try replacing everyone, so you will see that the total number of possibilities that come out are, so just see, time starts from 00 to 2359, right? This is hour, this is minute, right? So how many possible choices are there, right? So there are total 24 choices for this position, right? 0001 till 23. And how many possible choices are here? 60. 00, 01 to 59. So it is 24 into 60, that comes out to be 1/4 this, right? So this is something that the question is asking us. So again, since it was pretty boring to code, so what I have done is I've made a utility function. So suppose whatever be the test case, like for example, I'll take the first one. That is question mark 500. So what I have done is break this string into two parts. One part is this, one part is this. This is the hour part and this is the minute part, right? Right? This is the hour part, this is the minute part. Now what you do? You just see what are the valid hour values that you can have, irrespective of time, right? Irrespective of time. So what are the possible values that you can have here? So the first position has a question mark, right? So what I've done here, I have basically tried to replace it with all the possible digits, right? So I've applied a complete brute force. What I've done here is hour and minutes, both are having two digits, right? Both are having two places to check for validity, right? So I've picked up hour. In this case, it is question mark 5. What I've done is I have tried to put all the possible values here, right from 0 to 9. And when I come to this position, I see that it is not a question mark. This position already has a digit. So I consider only this digit. Though I traverse the loop, but I just consider this digit. So I have generated all the possibilities. I'll show that in my code. And I have checked whether it's valid or not. What is the validity check? That the R should lie between 00 to 23. Right, 23. So if my value, the generated value, lies between this, I add that into a set. Why I add it into a set? Because set contains unique values. The property of set is it's a combination of unique values, right? So the algorithm that I'm using is basically can generate duplicate values as well, right? So that is why it can generate duplicate values. I'll show that in the code, that since I'm running a loop now, so when I run a loop, this 5 can occur multiple times for multiple combinations. So that is why. So in short, I've tried to replace every question mark here by a nested loop, a 10 cross 10 loop, right? And similarly, I do the same thing for minute. I take another hash set and I add all the possible values here. Suppose there are two question marks, so I try to put all the 10 values here, all the 10 values here. I add that into the set, and finally I'll have two sets, one for hour and one for minute. So I just multiply it, that r dot size into minute dot size, because it contains all the valid values of r, it contains all the valid values of minute, so it will be this cross this, and finally I get my answer, right? So if I show my code, so it starts from line number 26. I have split the string into hours and minutes, so that it can be seen on 27 28. R is basically the first part, minute is basically the second part. And you can see on line number 30 and 31, I have instantiated an R set and a minute set. On line number 31, basically, I should have written set on the left-hand side, but again, I was coding pretty quickly, so just missed that. And then finally, I'm calling a utility function. So just see on line number 32 and 33, I'm calling the function twice, one for R, one for minute. So what are the values that function takes? First, the function takes the string. So in one time R, one and 1 minute. Then it takes a set in which it needs to insert the valid values. And the last parameter is what is the maximum value that is valid for the current string, right? Like for R, it will be 23, for a minute, it will be 59, right? So now we go on line number 3, the utility function. So you can see I have done exactly the same thing which I told you in the code. I'm running a nested loop that the first character can have 10 possible values, the second can have 10 possible values. Now I'm trying to generate the current value. So what I do, on line number 7, I check if the first character of my string, whether it's hour or minute, if the first character of my string is question mark, that means I need to find a possibility here. So what I do current equals to I. Else, if there is already a character, if there is already a symbol here, already a digit here, so you just take that digit. So token dot char at 0 minus 0. And then you do multiply it by 10, right? Because now it will move to 10's position. I need to consider the second character of the string, right? So I do token dot char at again. If that is a question mark, just add it, char plus equals to j, or you add the character that is already present there. If the current is less than maximum limit, just add that into your set, and then we are done. So again, I have tried to make it generic. and that is why I have used certain variables like max limit, passing a set, passing a token, and so on. And finally, I get my answer r set dot size into minute set dot size, right? So yeah, that's my solution. I hope you learned something new from this video. Do support it by giving up a thumbs up. Do subscribe to the channel. In case you have any queries, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to revert on each one of them. Also, do tell me what are the other approaches that you guys followed, and probably we can sync over that, right? So yeah, take care. Bye bye.